dear students, welcome to science class. I am your SM ma'am. We are learning the chapter matter and its states, and previous day we learned about solubility of substances, where we learned solubility of solids. Today we learn about solubility of liquids in water, solubility of gases in water. So solubility of liquids in water, some liquids like milk, honey, fruit juice, alcohol dissolve in water. These are called miscible liquids, whereas kerosene, oil, petrol do not dissolve in water. These are immiscible liquids. So liquids which do not dissolve with one another are called immiscible liquids, like two liquids here, water and kerosene, honey with liquid detergent, honey with corn syrup, next oil paint and water. So if we mix these two, like water, kerosene, honey, liquid detergent, so if we mix water and kerosene, they do not mix well. Honey and liquid detergent or corn syrup, they also do not mix. So these are immiscible. Then oil paint and water. Oil paint do not dissolve in water, but oil paint dissolve in kerosene, whereas honey dissolve in water. Liquid detergent dissolve in water, but it does not dissolve in honey, whereas oil paint does not dissolve in water. So these are the pair of immiscible liquids. Now immiscible liquids, they are given example. And 9 immiscible liquids, I think here, which do not mix with one another. And if you try to mix them, after some time, when that very beaker is kept rest, we can see the different colors and layers of the different liquids. Last, you can see there is a honey. So this is the liquid column of different liquids having different density which do not mix. So these are immiscible liquids. So first, in the bottom there is honey and corn syrup. So honey and corn syrup doesn't mix with each other. Then maple syrup, these also not mix with each other. Then milk doesn't mix. This soap, that means liquid soap, also not dissolve. Then water, vegetable oil, rubbing alcohol, lamp oil. So these liquid do not mix with one another. And to show the different layer, ping pong ball is given here, soda cap given, some beads are given, cherry tomato given here, dye given, popcorn kernel given here, nut bolt given, to show the different layer or the surface. So for separating these things, or immiscible, two immiscible liquids, the funnel that we use, that is called separating funnel. So here is the picture. In the right side you can see, this is the picture of separating funnel, where two liquids are given, liquid 1 and liquid 2, which are immiscible liquids. Now with the help of this top cork, when we open this one, the liquid which is at the lower side can be collected in a beaker at the bottom of the below the funnel. So this name of this funnel is called separating funnel. What is the name? Separating funnel. So separating funnels are used for separating immiscible liquids. Next, solubility of gases in water. Some gases dissolve in water, like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, ammonia dissolve in water. So with the help of the oxygen that dissolve in water, water animals like fish, here you can see fish, other animals like octopus, squids, whale, dolphin, etc., they respire. So they have a special organ which help them to take out oxygen from the water. Like here fish, you can see, with the help of gills, they can separate oxygen from the water. So oxygen, so water is taken by the mouth of the fish, then with the help of these gills they sieve, mane cheke nay, and then send oxygen to the other body parts, and the water, excess water, passes through this opening. So they only collect the oxygen and the water passes out. So the name of this special organ which help them to respire with the help of oxygen dissolved in water is called gills. Next, with the help of the carbon dioxide that dissolved in water, water plants, these are the water plants which can proceed photosynthesis process. Okay, so with the help of sunlight and water dissolve and the carbon dioxide dissolve in water, water plants continue photosynthesis process. Next we learn about change of state of matter. What is a change of state of matter? Matter changes its state from one form to another form by addition and removal of heat. That means by heating or by cooling. So addition means, addition of heat means heating process, and removal of heat means cooling process. So let us see, there is a picture where the state, that is the solid state, is given by ice. Then here there is water, that means liquid state, and this is water vapor, that is the gas state. So when energy, by adding energy, while we are going by the, going towards the right hand side, we are giving energy, and towards the left hand side we are removing heat energy. Here energy means here heat, so by adding heat, and here by removal of heat means by cooling. So when heat is added to ice, or ice is heated, by the process of melting it changes into water, that means in liquid state. When liquid is again heated, by the process of evaporation it changes into gas. When gas is cooled, by the process of condensation it changes into liquid again. When liquid is further cooled, then by the process known as freezing it changes into ice or solid. So solid change into liquid by melting process, liquid change into gas by evaporation process, gas change into liquid by condensation, and liquid change into solid by freezing process. So these are the process where one state change into another state by addition of heat and by removal of heat. So what we have learned? We have learned the process melting, the process of changing of solid state to liquid state by heating, the melting process of ice, sorry, it will be, there is a spelling mistake, it will be ice, I-C-E, melting of the melting point, sorry, it is a melting point, the melting point of ice is 0 degree Celsius. Next, evaporation, the process of changing of liquid to gaseous state by heating, it is the evaporation. So evaporation takes place in all temperature, and when there is a particular temperature, the liquid start boiling and change into gas is called boiling, and boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. Next, condensation, the process of changing of gas into liquid state by cooling is called condensation. All of you know from the water bodies like pond, river, etc., water evaporation go up above, where water vapor condense and form cloud. So cloud is formed by condensation process, where the vapor condense by the cooling process and change into cloud. Next, freezing, the process of changing of liquid state to solid state by removal of heat, and the freezing point of ice is 0 degree centigrade and boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. So today we have learned the different state change of different state of matter, where the names are melting, evaporation, condensation and freezing. Where melting and evaporation are done by, these two processes are done by adding heat, where condensation and freezing is done by or happen by cooling process. Some matters are there which directly change from solid to gas, like camphor, naphthalene, mean corpur, naphthalene. Eki jodi heat deya hoy directly solid theke gas e change hoye jay. Okay, again the gaseous state of camphor or naphthalene when we cooled directly change into solid. So some things are there, some matters are there. These are the examples. দেখবে কর্পূর বা ন্যাপথলিনকে এমনি রেখে দিলে আস্তে আস্তে ছোট হয়ে যায়, তো মানে কি হয় সলিডটা আস্তে আস্তে ডাইরেক্টলি গ্যাসিয়াস স্টেটে চেঞ্জ হয়ে যায়। এগেন অলসো ইউ হ্যাভ সিন দ্যাট হোয়েন ওয়াটার ইজ পোর্ড ইন দ্য ফ্লোর আফটার সাম টাইম দ্য ওয়াটার ইভাপোরেট অ্যান্ড চেঞ্জ ইন টু ওয়াটার ভ্যাপার, দ্যাট মিন্স ইভাপোরেশন প্রসেস টেক্স প্লেস ইন অল টেম্পারেচার। But when you heat water with high heat energy and the energy reaches to 100 degree Celsius, then it start boiling and change into water vapor or steam. So what we have seen? We have seen that state of change of matter happens by the molecular arrangement of the change of molecular arrangement of the matter. So how the change of molecular arrangement happen? So for this go to the next slide. Molecular change of arrangement means, here suppose in solid, this is a solid, you know in solid the molecules are very closely packed, so the intermolecular force is maximum. When solid is heated, the molecules started vibrating more or dancing more. So when they dance or vibrate more by getting heat, they move far away. That means the intermolecular force between the two molecules become less. For this, they move apart. So the intermolecular space increases and they do not remain like a solid state having fixed shape and fixed volume. When heated, they lose their shape and take the shape of the container, which is known as liquid state. You know, liquid state do not have, sorry, this is solid. When it is heated, change into liquid. And you know, liquids do not have fixed shape but have volume. Next, when liquid is heated again, then the molecules move far apart from each other, aro dure dure chole jay. So the molecules move far apart from each other, so intermolecular force become least. So by getting the heat energy, the liquid molecules started vibrating more and more, so the intermolecular force become less and the intermolecular space become maximum and the molecules become free. So they move in all direction here and there and continuously move here and there, collide with the walls of the container, and this very state, you know, is known as gas state. So in gas states, the molecules are free to move. Gas do not have fixed shape and volume because the intermolecular force is least, so the bonding between the molecules become less. Again, when gas is cooled or by removal of heat, again the vibration or the movement of the particle become less, and so the particles again come behave like a so the particles come down and change into liquid state. When liquid is being cooled again, the vibration of the molecule come down more and they become close to each other and get the shape and size and fix shape and size and volume and become solid. So here we can see how the molecular arrangement gets changed by addition and removal of the heat. So for this molecular change of arrangement, the state of the matter also change. So student, thank you today this much, and you enjoy the video and along with it read your book line by line. Bye.